We are in the author's studio at Book Expo America 2012 in New York City, and right now we're sitting with Marcia Dawkins. She's written a book called Clearly Invisible, Racial Passing and the Color of Cultural Identity. Hello, Marcia.
Hi.
Now, this is your first attempt at a book, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
And how was the experience?
It was a wonderful experience. It was really great to really dig into some old stories and make them new again and give people an opportunity to figure out what passing is all about.
You got to explain to me right off the bat. What is passing?
Sure. Passing is this idea of presenting yourself differently than you think you are or than society says you are in order to succeed, survive, find love, or even find people to harm in some cases.
Well, your book is already receiving high praise from what I understand, completely changing the discussion about racial passing. All right, so Marcia, I need to ask you, are you yourself a passer?
Of course I am. And actually, I argue in the book that everybody is a passer, that we present this strategy differently over the course of our lives in order to get ahead and meet our goals. But my story actually isn't about racial passing. Interestingly, through the course of writing this book, I realized that I was an age passer. And so very quickly...
Explain, yeah.
Okay, very quickly. When I was just an elementary school kid in Queens, New York, my parents wanted to put me in all-day school in a better school district. But I had to be over 5 years old, and I wasn't. So we kind of went Queen style and made it look as though I was 5 years old and then had to pass in terms of age. But I was always very concerned that the other kids would find out. There was a lot of things I couldn't do as a result. And so this idea of passing, I've realized through the course of the book, has kind of hit home with me in this very personal way.
All right. You know, the passing thing, in a lot of ways, it sounds like out and out lying.
That is actually one definition that people have used over the years. But and that's why passing kind of gets a bad rap. But part of why I'm changing the conversation is to say, hey, wait a minute, maybe we actually need to think about how we identify generally, and maybe those identities are really the lie.
You know, I noticed on the jacket copy, very, very odd, there is a white supremacist who's trying to pass as white. I don't get that.
Most people don't. In fact, I've gotten so many tweets and so much email asking if this is a typo, and it actually isn't. It's the story, the most recent story of a phenomenon I found out a lot about. We hear a lot about it in World War II, but the story I talk about in my book is this guy named Leo Felton, who's currently in prison in Boston, who is half Jewish and half black and a raging white supremacist. And it was a fascinating story to look into what he had to say about race and identity.
That's a very confused man, isn't it?
Yes. Yes, it is. But he also, despite his confusion, raises some interesting points that really made me think about what race is and isn't and how it can enrage so many people.
Marcia, the book's coming out right in the midst of a presidential election cycle. So I'm wondering, Barack Obama, Mitt Romney, do they kind of pass themselves off as something other than what they are?
I was going to say these are two of my favorite passers, actually. Neither is super successful, I would argue, because we're actually having this conversation about it, right? A successful passer is the one we'll probably never get to write a book about. But nevertheless, Mitt Romney and Obama have been accused of passing. Obama, of course, in terms of his citizenship status. Mitt Romney, in terms of his ethnicity. Is he really part Mexican or not? Is he part of the 1% or not? All of these different identities begin to come into play in this presidential election, and I think we'll see it play out.
I would imagine you're getting some pushback from people who don't agree with your takes at times. What are you hearing from folks about the whole passing phenomenon?
Most people say that passing is passé, actually, and I argue precisely the opposite, that we are in this new racial era where, because of changing demographics, because of our president, because of people like Mitt Romney with these diverse backgrounds, that this is really a conversation that should have ended 40 or 50 years ago. But the fact that we have someone like Leo Felton, who's in prison right now, or someone like me, who's an age passer, I think goes to show that the phenomenon is alive and well.
The reason I ask it is, I'm imagining there are a lot of people in denial.
Yes. Yes. A lot of people just say, I am who I am, and I don't need to explain that to anybody else, or have these issues of lower or stigmatized identity, perhaps, I should say.
I would imagine that there's another book in you, maybe even a follow-up to this.
Yes, actually, there is. I'm looking at these issues with regard to my favorite rapper, Eminem, and how he's a racial and age and other type of passer as well. So stay tuned for that. I'll be back.
All right. Well, Marcia, thank you very much. Very interesting subject and a pioneering work, from what I understand. So once again, the book is called Clearly Invisible, Racial Passing and the Color of Cultural Identity. She is Marcia Dawkins. Thank you, Marcia.
Thank you. Pleasure.